Alright, guys. Well, it has just collapsed into just another gray, gloomy, drizzly, yuck day here. In the collapse of global industrial civilization here as the fall of 2021 plods along, we have reached the last day of September. Yes, that would be Thursday, September 30th, 2021, here in the collapse. And so Thursday is when I've started this new roundup of stories from what I think is one of the greatest chroniclers of the collapse that I have, right up next to mongabay.com, and that would be oilprice.com. For the few people on the planet interested in listening to what these fossil fuel investment newsletters have to say about the situation on the planet. So, of course, while the mainstream media is sitting here, you know, covering this UN meeting and all of this crap and pumping up the Green New Deal and all of this, it's just business as usual here, the rest of the planet. So since you're not going to find a little bit of this on the mainstream media, but the vast majority of this, so we have to come over and listen to the fossil fuel investors to get a taste of reality about fossil fuels and what the true picture, the truth of fossil fuels. Okay, we're going to start out hearing from the CEO of Baker Hughes. If you're not familiar with who Baker Hughes is, I don't know if Baker Hughes is the single biggest oil field major out there. You know, Baker Hughes just kind of supplies oil fields. That's a oversimplification, but anyway, they're planet eaters, all right? Trust me, Baker Hughes. Who is this guy? Simonelli. They do not even give. I guess we're supposed to know who Simonelli's. They never give his first name. Okay. Fossil fuels are here to stay. That is the message one oil field major CEO had for those watching the surge of gas prices in Europe. They are here to stay because they, meaning fossil fuels are here to stay because they help to ensure a country's energy security. Wow. Quote, hydrocarbons are here to stay. All right, I'm glad you cleared that up, Mr. Simonelli, without the first name. Okay, so let's break that one down. The fossil fuels are here to stay. Okay, how about this one? The energy crisis is sending oil, gas, and coal prices soaring, and we're particularly going to center on coal in this story. There is some delusion out there that coal, that king coal, has been dethroned. All right, these are the takeaways. The European energy crisis, which we talked a lot about last week in this rant, is going global as the lack of natural gas supply begins to influence the coal and oil markets. Meaning, so if you can't find that clean burning natural gas, you're gonna go to whatever's cheapest. Cut the crap here, people. Whatever is cheapest is what consumers, what the big power companies are going to supply to the consumers. That is all consumers care about. I'm not acting like I'm on a high horse. I use natural gas, well, propane, to heat this house, but if I could think of a cheaper way to do it, I would. People don't give a damn about their consumer and lifestyle choices' effects on the planet. Okay? Wake up and smell the coffee. You can talk till you're blue in the face how you give a damn about how your consumer and lifestyle choices are affecting this planet. It is you are going to make the choice. What is the cheapest? This is this is really rocket science. Okay. Oil prices are now set to break the $80 market as gas to oil switching increases oil demand amid continued supply outages. And don't forget, coal prices have hit a 13-year high in Europe and record levels in Asia as more coal is called upon as a cheaper alternative than gas. All right, just ahead of the winter season, Europe's natural gas crunch created a snowball effect in global energy markets. What started as very low gas inventories in Europe during the summer is now spilling over into oil. Natural gas and coal prices all over the world, with no quick fix or signs of a major short-term correction in sight. Oil prices are now headed to $80 a barrel. Blah, blah, blah. However, as the winter heating season in the northern hemisphere approaches, gas and power prices in Europe are surging, driving up demand for coal, and prices in Europe and globally as more coal is used in the power sector. At the same time, economies are rebounding from the corona panic slump, with energy-intensive industries growing. Yes. Because the supply of oil, gas, and coal is struggling to catch up with recovering demand, energy prices are rallying around the world. Consumers and industries in Europe have already started to feel the pinch from record gas and power prices. Industries across Europe and more China, which they talk about, are scaling back operations due to record natural gas and power prices, threatening to deal a blow to the post-corona panic recovery. Meanwhile, utilities are firing up more coal-powered electricity generation, pushing demand for coal higher. Yes, despite the European Union's pledges to be a net zero bloc by 2050, European coal prices have hit a 13-year high as coal supply to Europe remains constrained and utilities fire up more coal power plants amid surging natural gas prices. The rally in natural gas prices is also spurring on global demand for coal. Both China and India are replenishing their low stocks of coal, driving coal prices in Asia to record highs. Good old Goldman Sachs has recently nearly doubled its price projection for coal prices in Asia from $100 per ton to $190 per ton due to sky-high gas prices ahead of the winter heating season. In China, a power supply crunch may be looming amid soaring coal and gas prices and electricity demand. Chinese authorities are ordering some factories in the heavy industries to curtail their operations or shut down entirely to avoid a power supply crisis. Yes, the gas and coal price spikes globally are then set to raise demand for crude oil in the winter as a substitute fuel. Analyst in OPEC itself says a gas to oil switch and continued recovery in global oil demand have analysts in major oil trading houses predicting oil will hit $80, potentially $100 a barrel next year. And there's actually an article, not surprisingly, on oilprice.com, some analyst predicting $200 a barrel oil next year as demand goes through the roof. Okay, and take a wild guess who is cranking back up due to this as oil has passed $70, heading to $80. All right, U.S. shale is finally ready to drill. I would say ready to drill again. All of this people thinking that the corona panic, I was one of them. Okay, I was one of these clueless morons thinking that the corona panic had put the final nail in the coffin on shale oil and gas. You know, I live right above the Pennsylvania border where fracking is completely legal 10 miles from here. I have a big fracking supply operation 3 miles from this house in New York. My neighbors up and down this road cannot wait for fracking to be legalized again. Now that Andrew Cuomo has been run out of town on a witch hunt, the frackers celebrating. But I'm getting off on a gas fracking in New York rant when we're supposed to be talking about shale oil fracking in the American West. Okay. U.S. crude oil production is set to rise by 800,000 barrels per day next year, the Financial Times reported this week. This is hardly surprising given that U.S. oil prices are now around $70 per barrel, making shale wells profitable again. Do you think so? Bring out the champagne as Joe Biden, that Save the Planet president. Man, got a tick. I need to pull off this little dog. Now what am I going to do with this tick? You know, this is weird. As soon as the weather starts turning cold, I start getting ticks on a little. So I'm going to put this tick. I'm going to take one more sip of this water. I hope I don't forget about this water. Anyway, what was I talking about? You know, that U.S. President Joe Biden talking about, you know, our carbon promises. Well, let's look at the bigger picture, because I meant to read this one before the shale one. But, okay. All of these stories coming out of the summer of 2021. Actually, I guess going back to 2020. You know, all of this stuff about corona panic, killing fossil fuels and all that. Well, let's look at what really happened last year behind the scenes. U.S. energy exports exceed imports for the first time ever. A new milestone. All right. A new milestone has been reached in the global energy markets. For the first time ever on record, the value of U.S. energy exports exceeded the value of imports based on 2020 data. There was an energy trade surplus of $27 billion last year as the value of coal, electricity, natural gas, and petroleum exports surpassed that of the value of the imports. And for the first 6 months of this year, the trade value of energy was a surplus of $9 billion. Even as non-energy goods exports experienced a record $938 billion deficit. Yes. The bulk of the U.S. energy trade is petroleum. Yes. But natural gas is the one to watch. Yep, yep, yep. But, let's see, as long as we're, you know, as I say, I got kind of out of order. I want to get back to shale. So anyone who thinks that shale oil and gas and fracking has been defeated, I think we can probably thank Hillary Clinton for this on one level. People forget that as Barack Obama's, you know, I think Barack Obama, didn't he say he invented fracking? Or was that Al Gore saying he invented the internet? But of course, you know, people tend to forget that it was Hillary Clinton was the head of the Secretary of State under Barack Obama, and probably the main job she had as Secretary of State was basically taking fracking planet-wide. So this may or may not have something to do with Hillary Clinton and Barack Obama. But we're going to go down to Argentina. The world's fastest growing shale play just keeps on breaking records. Argentina's Vaca Muerta, meaning dead cow. I think Vaca Muerta means dead cow, if my Spanish is correct. Argentina's dead cow shale play, having registered strong growth in oil and gas production and well activity levels in recent months, has emerged as the world's fastest growing major shale basin. A record number of wells were completed and put on production, propelling the field's oil and gas output to new highs in July and August, and charting a course for even more growth by year's end. Yes. this surge from dead cow is poised to lift Argentina's countrywide oil production to the highest level in years. Yes. Although complete data for September is not yet available, there is no doubt that the third quarter of 2021 will set a new record for the number of horizontal wells, otherwise known as fracking wells, put on production in the dead cow. But from, guys, I could go on all day. We're going to look at two more because I realize I'm probably already talking to myself. Let's go over to Europe. Europe must act to avert an energy crisis this winter. With natural gas storage levels now at a 10-year low, just ahead of the winter heating season, Europe is facing hard choices from its limited range of options to alleviate the gas crisis. Governments across Europe have pledged to protect the most vulnerable consumers as soaring gas and electricity prices are hot potatoes that no ruling party or coalition wants to encounter. But the high energy price spike is here, and it could worsen as we enter the heating season in the Northern Hemisphere between November and March. Good luck on how they're going to do that. And of course, as we said, utilities are using more coal and other fuels to generate electricity at the expense of natural gas. Increased use of coal-fired power in the electricity mix is in direct conflict with the ambitions of the European Union and the UK to reach net zero emissions by 2050. The UK, which is pledged to phase out coal-fired power generation, had to fire up an old coal plant that was on standby in order to meet its electricity demand. Blah, blah, blah. But we're going to end up, I don't know whether we're going to end up in Lebanon or Israel, because we're having a resource war bubbling up, I guess offshore, where Lebanon and Israel wanting to cash in on this natural gas bonanza are in a little bit of a spat. Yes. Lebanon clashes with Israel over gas exploration. Anybody who does not understand what resource wars, the ramping up of resource wars, is going to look like. Here is just a tiny little peek into the future of the resource wars. Lebanon, already in full crisis mode, has rejected Israeli gas exploration in a disputed area, meaning offshore, in the Levant Basin. Israel has already signed a contract for exploration with Halliburton Corporation. What a shock. Halliburton signing contracts with Israel in a disputed area off the coast of Lebanon. This is a real shocker. Cannot imagine why Halliburton would be doing that. this is not an end to the negotiations over the disputed area. Rather, Lebanon objects to the fact that while UN-sponsored negotiations are still ongoing, Israel has jumped the gun by signing that contract with Halliburton. Lebanese Prime Minister Michael Aoun said this week that all exploration would be frozen until there is a resolution on the disputed areas. Yes, the area in question is an 860 square kilometer swath of the Mediterranean Sea. Negotiations are faltering at a time when Hezbollah is increasing its strength and maintains control of the area on the Lebanese-Israeli border. The horse jockeying for the top spot at Libya's national oil company has taken another twist. So, you know, anyway, guys, I could go on with this, but I think we get it. And I need to fire up some of this high-priced propane to cook me a BLT. I am still picking tomatoes out there, unbelievably. I still am getting my daily BLT, so I have to go out there and head to the garden one more time on this ugly day and give the natural gas market probably the frackers. I honestly don't know where the propane in this house comes from. I'm assuming that it was fracked in Pennsylvania. This is just a wild guess on my part. The electric heater you hear in the background, I think that is mostly hydroelectric energy from Niagara Falls, but I really don't know. Anyway, get out there and invest in fossil fuels while you still can and cash in on all of these ways to get rich off the collapse of a planet while you still can before all of your investments, you know, collapse the planet. Bye, guys. Okay, little dog. Did you survive?